Hi DIYers, Sterling with Alarm Grid here, and today we're going to show you how to install a 2 gig XCVR2 900 megahertz transceiver module inside of our 2 gig Go control panel. The panel comes equipped with an REC2 wireless receiver module, which is operating on the 345 megahertz range. That's a radio frequency range, not Wi-Fi, it's actually radio frequency or RF wireless. And that's how the panel communicates with our wireless sensors, door contacts, motion detectors, things like that. The 2 gig sensors operate on the 345 megahertz range, as well as the Honeywell wireless sensors. So, with that module installed, without needing to do anything else, you can learn in wireless devices. Now, this unit operates 900 megahertz range and 345 megahertz range. So, the 900 megahertz range is for the 2 gig TS1 wireless touchscreen keypad. So that touchscreen operates on a different frequency range because of the bidirectional functionality of that device. So whereas a sensor will just send a signal to here, the keypad's got to be able to request status from here, and therefore it operates on a different megahertz range. You can see that this has a little pigtail antenna right on here, which once we open this up and look at the existing REC2 does not have, so it's a higher powered antenna as well. This unit most times when you install this, it's to use the TS1 touchscreen keypad. It also is used with the 2 gig BRDG1-900 IP communicator, or the GoBridge IP communicator. So if you're going to do IP communications with your system, you'll also need to go ahead and replace your existing wireless receiver with this one. So now that we've explained why you would use this unit, we're going to show you how to install it. First thing we want to do whenever installing a module is take power and remove it from the panel. So to open the panel, there is a case screw at the top. We use our small flat Phillips head screwdriver and remove it. Then we use a flathead screwdriver. There are two tabs on the top. Insert into the tab and twist. Insert in the tab and twist, and we've popped the two tabs and the panel swings down. The panel does have a third arm which holds the panel to the back, but you never want to rely on that being connected when you open, because a lot of times it'll come undone and you don't want to be stressing your power wires by doing that. So just make sure when you first hit the two tabs that you swing down and carefully connect this third helping hand before actually getting into here. So we've got our 2 gig Go control opened up, and we want to go ahead and remove power. We want to disconnect our backup battery and our DC power input, which is on the other end connected to the transformer plugged into our normal wall outlet. That's how the panel gets power. So we hold down on the battery connector and disconnect the battery cable. Very simple, slides out. You do have to get a little force on there. Be careful not to pull this connector out. That's why I recommend putting a little pressure on the unit so you don't pull it from the circuit board. And we still have power. That message you heard was a low battery. So the panel's telling us tamper, yes, the cover's open. Low battery, yes, we've disconnected our battery from the panel. So now we disconnect the DC power. We are using a barrel plug instead of hooking into the screw terminals for power. So it just simply unplugs like that. And our panel is dark and our buttons don't work. We are powered down. So as described, the panel comes shipped and installed with an REC2-345E, which is the standard 345 megahertz receiver. And you simply pull directly out from the board. Very simple, no screws. There's 5-pin connector on the left, 3-pin connector on the right. Grip it on both sides and pull straight out. Removes the REC2. Now, we have our CVR2, and you can see, XCVR2, and you can see that they are nearly identical units aside from the little antenna connector at the bottom. On the back side, you have very similar 3 pins, 5 pins, and it's as simple as lining up the pins and pushing down on this foam pressure pad until you've pushed it as close to the panel as you can. do not bend or alter the angle of this antenna. It's at this angle by design. This is the best angle for best maximum reception out to any touchscreen keypads in your house. So, final step, reconnect the backup battery. Always connect your battery before your power. And then final step, plug in our DC power. We have to be careful about this wire now because we don't want it to hit this antenna. So I'm gonna install it like so. And when we close it up, we just wanna make sure we're not gonna be pinching onto that antenna. And it hinges at the bottom first.
System disarmed, ready to arm.
So I've actually tucked the wire and snap it shut at the top. Take our case cover screw. And screw it down, nice and tight. And our panel is secure on the wall again. And we now have a system that's capable of transmitting 345 megahertz and 900 megahertz. We hope you've enjoyed our video on the installation of the 2GIG-XCVR2. We invite you to subscribe to our channel. If you have any questions on when to use the XCVR2 or how to install it to your 2GIG Go control, please email support@alarmgrid.com.